everybody. My name is Sarah. I am one of the studio teachers at Small World Yoga. I'm also an outreach teacher. Right now I'm teaching at Big Picture High School. I'm teaching students and teachers over there. And I'm also with Backfield in Motion, an after school program for middle school boys, which both of those locations just bring me lots of joy. And I'm so excited to be a part of this gratitude and grounding series with Small World. And I hope you are enjoying this series. Let's get started. So find a seat, any comfy seat, and we're just gonna take a moment to, tune within. So find a seat, place your hands somewhere in your lap, sit up nice and tall, and then if it feels comfortable, you can close your eyes or just gently look down. And first, I want you to pay attention to any sounds around you. If you're in your home, you might have someone else kind of bustling around in a different room. Maybe you hear air conditioning. I can hear traffic and construction outside. Always the case. Right, and as you're noticing these sounds, try to develop a sense of non-attachment to them. So we're not here to label them, get distracted by them, judge them. They're just there as part of this present moment. And then tune into your physical body. So same thing, I want you to get aware of any physical sensations in the body while you avoid, attachment to those sensations. So you're just noticing them, letting them come up to your awareness, and then you let them go. If your hips are tight, your shoulders, just notice and move on. And drawing even further inward, I want you to pay attention to your breathing. So no need yet to start to deepen that breath, just notice how it's showing up for you right now. Maybe you notice that you're filling up more into the chest, maybe it's more into the belly. Maybe you can feel cool air coming into the nose as you inhale, warm air coming out of the nose as you exhale. And then lastly, I want you to bring your attention to your thoughts. So just like we've been doing, you're noticing your thoughts without kind of getting lost in them, getting distracted by them. You're just seeing them for what they are, letting them come up, and then letting them go. A deep breath in, and then sigh out of your mouth. Good. Do that two more times. Fill up all the way, and then sigh out. Last time, fill up, and then let it go. Start to open your eyes. You can wiggle fingers and toes, kind of gently waking up the body. And we're going to get moving. We're going to do a little bit of a hips flow for the next 30-ish minutes. So I want you to just start with your neck. We're going to move down to the hips, but right now I just want you to focus on finding little spots in your neck and just kind of rotating, gently waking up. You can start to roll shoulders, start to move, you might find more sensation in the body than you did when we were just sitting. You start to go the other way with the shoulders. Right, now I want to challenge you to not focus so much on the sensations as something negative, but just something neutral, just something that simply is. Any kind of shoulder movements that feel good. I kind of like to alternate sometimes. Good. And then place your left hand down the floor beside you and reach up with the right. Reach. Take your breath in and stay. Good. Come to the middle and then we're going to switch right hand down, left hand up. Reach. Breathe in and out. Take both hands out in front of you. You can kind of like spider walk the fingers, right? So this is our first hip opener. And so you're gonna get to choose how far forward you want to fold, right? And I kind of like to find some swaying back and forth. Just very gently saying hello to the hips. Good, and walk the hands back. Meet me in a tabletop position. So however you want to get there, hands and knees. And I want you to check on your alignment. So you've got shoulders directly over the wrists, hips directly over the knees. So you might need to, you know, readjust how far apart your knees and hands are. And then we're just going to move through cat and cow. All right, so you've got cow reaching up, breathing in. And then catch, rounding through the spine, look in toward your belly button, exhale. And just move back and forth. Find your own pace based on your breath. Really, you can find any movements here that feel good. You might take a little bit of a side movement here. Maybe you kind of find one little spot, kind of wiggle around because it feels good. Anything goes. Good, and slowly come back to your neutral tabletop and come to downward facing dog. So lift the hips, press into the hands, press your chest into your thighs. Take a deep breath in and sigh it out. One more in through the nose and out through the nose. Walk your feet up to your hands. We'll take our first sun a super slow to your halfway lift. Unfold. And then reach all the way up, extend the mountain pose. And then all the way back down. Halfway lift, breathe in. Plant the hands, step it back, high through a plank. You can lower the knees as you go. Upward facing dog or cobra. Downward facing dog. Good. Take a breath in and a breath out. And step forward. Halfway lift. Fold. Mat pose, fill up. And then bow forward, exhale. Lifting up halfway, breathe in. Plant the hands, step it back, breathe out. Upward facing dog or cobra, downward facing dog. All right, we're going to add on to our sun salutation. So this time, take a breath in and to breath out. Step the right foot forward, crescent lunge. Open up to warrior two. Reach back, inhale, reverse your warrior. Plant the hands, exhale, chaturanga. Upward facing dog, downward facing dog. Left foot forward, crescent lunge, breathe in, reach up. Warrior two, exhale. Inhale, reach it back. Hands to mat, breathe out. Take three rounds of breath in your downward facing dog. And of course, child's pose is always available. two, exhale. Reverse your warrior, breathe in. Hands to mat, float through, breathe out. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Crescent lunge, left foot forward, breathe in. Open up, breathe out. Reach it back, inhale. Chaturanga, exhale. Back to down dog. Kind of reset. Warming up the body, warming up the hips. Take two more rounds of breath. Good, one more. Empty it out. Right foot forward, crescent lunge. Warrior two. Reverse. And float. Left foot forward, reach up, crescent lunge. Warrior two. Reverse. And float. Back in, downward facing dog, take three rounds of breath. Last one. Inhale, lift your right heel to the ceiling, and then step it through, low crescent lunge this time. So your back knee is going to be down. And you can have, you know, back toes tucked or untucked, depending on what feels better on the back knee. And then plant your left hand on the mat and reach up with the right hand. So we're finding a hip opener and a twist. And breathe here. Take three more. Open up more on your exhales. Good for two. Last one. Good, slowly bring the right hand back down. So you're framing the front foot between your two hands. And we're just gonna start to find half split, coming back to your lunge, back and forth. All right, so this does not have to be some contortionist half split. This knee is as straight or as bent as you want it to be. Right, we're just focusing on sending the hips back and forward, nice and slow. Right, you can start to match this with your breath. If you inhale as you go forward and exhale as you go back. Back and forth, following your breath. As you're doing this, you might find that you can open up just a little bit more, go back a little bit farther. Dynamic stretching, keeping everything warm. But the next time you go back into your half split, just stay there. Flex your right toes back towards your face. Right, if you're having trouble reaching down, you can grab blocks, a water bottle, pop your hands up on those. And keep pressing your hips back to the back of your mat. Keep breathing. Good. Alright, slowly come forward into your low lunge. Plant your hands, send your right foot back, downward facing dog. Take a second, just notice if one hip feels different than the other. Right, again, just bringing awareness to sensations in the body. And then step your left foot forward, low crescent lunge. Back knees down, again, choose between tucked or untucked toes. Plant the right hand and find your twist. Press the floor away with your right hand, press the power of the right shoulder. Inhale, open up, exhale. Four more.
three, two. Last one, fill up. Twist open. Excellent. Now bring your left hand back down, and we're going to go between the half split and the low lunge. Moving back and forth. The front toes lift as you go back, and then they go back down as you move forward. And again, there's no pressure here to be like a gymnast, a ballerina, contortionist. You're just exploring the range of motion in your hips, exactly as it is right now. Might be different than it would be tomorrow, might be different than it was yesterday. It's just about right now. Matching this with your breath. Inhale to come forward. Exhale to go back. Right, you don't have to stay with my rhythm. You can be faster or slower. Maybe not super fast, but you know. Do your thing. Good. Okay, the next time you come back into your half split, hang out here. Keep flexing the left toes back towards your left shin. And also see if you can get really long through your spine so you're not like completely hunched over, but you've got your chest pulling through your arms. Keep breathing. See if you can go a little straighter with the leg, maybe. And slowly come back into your low lunge, plant both hands, meet back in the downward facing dog. Right, and again, kind of bicycle through the knees and see if you notice a difference between the hips now. Maybe they feel more open and more even. Maybe they don't, and maybe you're not sure. Right? There's no right answer here. Okay, one more time. Lift your right heel straight up. This time, step it forward outside of the right hand. Lizard lunge. So again, you're going to kind of choose your adventure. So you can stay up like this. Right foot on the outside of the right hand. Maybe the back heel or the back knee comes down. You can stay right here. This is a great lunge. Maybe, if you want more, you start to come down to the forearms. Right, maybe you get down here and you're like, no, I'm good, come back up. Totally valid. Explore, see what works. You can also come to, you know, a block. So now we're starting our longer holds for our hip openers. All right, so you might have more intense sensations in the body as we start to hold these deeper shapes. And we've been kind of talking about not having negative labels or judgments or attachments to those sensations. Trying to be neutral. And now I want to challenge you to try being grateful for the sensations. I know. If it's intense, it's like, I don't want to be grateful for this, I just want to be done. Right? It's not about ignoring how you feel or magically feeling something that you don't. It's simply about choosing to be grateful, even if you don't feel like it. Even if it feels inauthentic, just try it on. Tell yourself, I choose to be grateful for lizard lunge. Take three more rounds of breath here. You might start to peel open the right foot. Just one more round of breath. Slowly press to the hands if you were down on the forearms. Tuck the back toes. Lift the back knee. Send the front foot back. Downward facing dog. All right, we've got lizard lunge on the left side to be grateful for. Here we go. Okay,
Left foot steps up on the outside of the left hand. Back knee is down if you want it to be. Elbows come down if you want them to. All right, so whatever version of lizard you're in, just practice choosing to be grateful for it. Right, it's easy to feel and be grateful for quote unquote good things, you know, happy things, things that we as a society deem positive and, you know, all these sorts of things. But what if you could choose to be grateful for what we would consider difficult things? Hip openers, even things like flat tire or losing your job. Right? Like, these are obviously different levels of intensity of quote unquote difficult things. But, you know, like if you get a flat tire, you could be grateful for that in the sense that you now get to experience what it's like to call AAA and wait for them to come. And maybe you're listening to a CD you found under your seat as you wait and it reminds you of your childhood. I don't know. You know, like, you're grateful for the experience, the confidence you built in yourself and your ability to handle difficult and inconvenient situations. You know, I lost my job earlier this year, and I'm choosing to be grateful for that and the opportunities that has opened up for me, as opposed to, you know, just feeling bitter about it, feeling angry. I know we're still in lunch and I'm talking, but it's intentional, I promise. Take three more rounds of breath. One more deep breath. Press into your hands, come up. Tuck the back toes, lift the back knee. Front foot goes back, downward facing dog. Turn to face you just for this next shape, which you can stay just as you are. Come into half pigeon. So with half pigeon, you're going to draw the right knee into the right wrist. Front of the back leg is flat to the floor. And again, you can stay up on your hands. You can come down to the forearms. You can even come farther. Maybe you place the forehead on the backs of your hands. So just choose your adventure. Yeah, and just try on the choice to feel grateful for half pigeon. Like, how many times does your teacher call this and you're like, oh, here we go. And you get in it and you spend the entire time kind of like internally complaining about it. Like, oh, my hip hurts and like, this is terrible. How long am I going to be here? I have better things to do, like let me go ahead and plan the rest of my evening. What am I going to have for dinner? What if instead the only thought you have is gratitude? You know, being grateful for the chance to work on the hips, work on your flexibility. Chance to practice feeling what you feel without all of the chatter. You know, our minds just constantly are thinking and moving forward and analyzing and judging and labeling. And your yoga practice, my yoga practice, is the practice of quieting the mind, making things simple. Yeah, what can you choose to be grateful for in this position, in this shape? breath. Is going to be frog. You had to know that was coming. Okay, so belly facing the floor, bring the knees as wide as they'll go. And then make sure your shins are parallel to each other. You can stay up on the hands. You can come onto a pillow, a bolster, a block, whatever you've got. You can come onto the forearms. Again, maybe your forehead reaches your hands. It doesn't matter. This is our longest and most intense hold, right? Like, we know what frog is. We know what frog feels like. Can you be grateful for frog? It doesn't mean it sucks any less. It just means you're grateful for the fact that your body can attempt any sort of semblance of frog, right? Like, you're grateful for the time you have for your yoga practice. Choosing to be grateful in difficult times gives me my agency back, right? Like, no one's forcing you to be in fog right now. I don't know if you're doing it, but you do, and you chose it. And so choose to be grateful for it rather than, you know, being grumpy. Screaming at me and I'm shaking and sweating and thinking, like, God, why did I come here? And I'm grateful for all of those moments because they've made me who I am. They've strengthened my body and my spirit. And so that's what frog is doing for you right now. It might not feel great, but you'll be glad you did it. Deep breath. Back to your seat just like we started, sitting up tall, hands in your lap. Close your eyes one more time and then just notice what has changed, if anything, in your body. You know, do your hips feel different? Does your breath feel different? choose over and over and over to be grateful. Bring your thumbs up to your forehead. Together we bow and we say, Namaste. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time.